Hello chess lovers, Storen here, and in this video I want to share with you a very instructive attacking game played by the 7th Women's World Chess Champion Maya Ciburdanidze. Her opponent is German chess player Hans Hofmann, and the game was played in 1989 at Lugano Open. Lugano is a town in Switzerland. In this game Ciburdanidze had white pieces and she opened up with e4, to which Hofmann responded with Sicilian defense c5. Knight f3 e6, knight c3, and after a6 we have the open Sicilian d4, c takes d4, knight takes d4. The good old con variation is on the board, queen c7, g3. Other popular alternatives are bishop e2, bishop d3, bishop e3, but in the game white prepared the fianchetto of the kingside bishop, and in return black advanced on the queenside bishop b7, white castled kingside d6, rook e1, knight d7, a4, white is somewhat weakening black's pawn structure on the queen side, and after rook takes a4 we have knight gf6, which is a mistake. At this point it's better, for example, to play bishop e7. It's very important to have this bishop on the e-file, and in case white goes for a piece sacrifice like knight d5, yes, already black king has a nice defensive shield. And now if I move like bishop h3 with the threat of bishop takes e6, then black has knight c5 move. But in our game, after rook takes a4, we have knight f6, which stepped into this destructive knight d5 piece sacrifice. As you remember, we have already seen this move, and that was made in a game played between Peter Daly and Jan Hein Donner. 28 years later, Ciburdanidze is repeating the same sacrifice. In case you missed that video, the link will be in the comment section. So black accepted the piece sacrifice, after which white manages to open up the e-file. He takes d5, discovered check, king d8. In Daly Donner game mentioned above, black played knight d5 and stepped into this nasty pin, but in our game, white decided to find a safe shelter for his king on the queen side, king d8. Here comes knight c6 check, bishop takes c6, d takes c6, knight b6, and rook d4. White is now starting to put a pressure on d6. White's next move can be bishop f4. For example, if bishop e7, then bishop f4, and if knight c8, then c4, c5 can follow. In our game, after rook d4, we have d5 and c4. Although I have to tell you that already at this point, bishop takes d5 is playable, but this requires a little bit of calculation, which probably Ciburdanidze failed to do over the board. Now if bishop d6, then bishop f4 is winning, or if queen d6, then white can play queen a5 check, and if queen c7, then bishop g5 check is coming, and then rook d1, yes, this exposed black king has no chance of surviving, and then bishop f4, the game is over. Instead, in our game, after d5, we have c4, which is also a strong move, but it's not as strong as bishop takes d5. Queen takes c6. By blocking the long diagonal, black is managing to win this dangerous pawn, but is doing it at the cost of giving up the central d-pawn. C takes d5, queen c5, and there it goes, d6. Yes, the d-pawn looks very scary, and black's position is totally paralyzed. Rook b8, here comes bishop f4, knight bd7, blocking the d-pawn's further advance, and queen d2. This time white wants to harass black queen by playing rook c1, and after this strange looking h6 move we have rook c1. All in all, black's position is so terrible that it's difficult to find a good continuation. h6 turned out to be black's best choice, but here comes rook c1, queen b6, and queen c3. The threat is queen c7 check. Knight e8, black is covering the c7 square, but it turns out that it's not so easy to stop white from bringing into life her intentions. I guess you already figured out that Ciburdanidze's next move was queen c7 check. We have a queen sacrifice. Knight takes c7, Black accepted the queen sacrifice and we have d takes c7 check. King e8, of course, if here then you are stepping into a checkmate in one. That's why black played king e8, but here comes rook e4 check, bishop e7, and there it goes, another queen appears on the board. Knight takes b8, well, if queen takes b8, then simply bishop takes b8, followed by rook c8 check. In our game, after c takes b8 check, we have knight takes b8, but anyways, rook c8 check followed, and after king d7, white forced a resignation by switching into the attack the last piece. A very, very beautiful position, right, guys? Now, if you cover your king by playing queen e6, then simply bishop takes e6, and then rook takes h8. White has a huge material advantage. That's why, finally, after bishop h3 check, resignation followed. Quite possibly, Chiburdan is a new about Daily Donner game, but even if not, then finding knight d5 sacrifice is something which was really a very easy task for her to solve. Before this, typical Sicilian knight d5 sacrifices had been seen many times in her career. In the end, a chess puzzle for you where the task is to find that winning move for white. The winning move is very beautiful and I will wait for your answers in the comment section. Thanks for watching, here are more suggestions for you, feel free to check them out as well. I will see you in my next video. Take care!